Hi, everyone. Apparently, I'm the last but one speaker, so it's been a long day. But I'll try to bring a little bit of a different perspective. I actually, in the backstage, I was hearing the last speaker talk about how he's been in the industry for as long as he's worked. I've been in the industry most of my career as well. I stepped out for 2.5 years into auto tech, and I realized that there's one industry slower than telecom, and that was auto, so I came right back. Thank God I didn't go into aerospace. So thinking about the industry, it's a reflection. I didn't really prepare to say this, but I want to just contradict the last speaker on one point and then support him on another. The contradiction is, if you look at the industry that we are all part of, and very proudly part of, this industry actually has done massive good for this world. It has connected billions with voice, broadband, connectivity of all fashion. We are so used to it that we don't even think about it. But the industry for itself, I just remembered a statistic that I saw in one of the reports by BCG. They actually do an index of 33 industries in terms of total shareholder return. And telecom was 31 of 33 at 6% TSR. And the number one industry, no surprise, was tech, driven by the boom of AI in the last year at 20% shareholder return. 6% versus 20%. 31 out of 33. And then the other thing that stood out, there are players in the industry that actually do quite good, north of 15% shareholder return, but those are mostly in the infrastructure place. They're the ones that are setting up the towers or digging the fiber. They're not the ones offering the technology or offering the service, usually. So something for the industry to think about, and when I was thinking about my presentation, and this is the part I agree with my last presenter, actually, this industry has tremendous potential. And part of the reason that we have seen a different return profile of this industry is that we have been actually quite lean as to what we do by ourselves. When we go out in the market and we offer voice, we offer a terminal, we offer the network, somebody subscribes to that, and actually they go make calls to friends and family. Then we offer broadband service. The industry is basically the connectivity fabric, but does not take anything on top. It is very limited to the industry itself. If you think about the companies that make most money, they actually transform themselves into platforms. And platforms mean that somebody's going to come and innovate on top of you. Well, if there is one industry that everybody's innovated on top of, that's us. So why don't we get the platform returns in this industry? Because we haven't acted like platforms. We've acted like simple connectivity fabric. And I think that's where my presentation was going to be. So my presenter actually did a great job of laying out what we can do. We need to open up as an industry. And it's just not opening up our software. Okay, can we write software on a CPU, ARM-based, x86-based? Yes, we can. Instead of have verticalized products, can we go to open products? Yes, we can. Can we go from metal to cloud? Yes, we can. Will that change the shareholder returns in this industry? To be seen. So this industry does really well in generations that has great spectrum available to it and where it tries to be open. And the openness really comes, can you put more applications on top? And that's where my presentation is. We should think about what value we create as a platform and what value can we as an industry capture thereby. So I actually want to start with a few examples. And the few examples are actually not in actually offering broadband or voice subscriptions. These four examples are basically creation of value as a platform to other industries. The one on the top left is around the state of California. I flew in from San Francisco an hour and a half ago. So I should use that example. Essentially, what this says is that we're offering private networks to emergency call responders in the state of California. And this has proven to be immensely valuable because the state of California is notoriously known for wildfires. And by the time there is an emergency response, the wildfire has spread and creates a lot of destruction for value and life. Now, with a service like that, imagine the value creation. How much of that goes to the industry and how much goes on top? There's tremendous value being created if you can avoid a single wildfire. But imagine doing this in an industrialized way, and that's what we're doing in the state of California. Another example, If you look at what we're doing with Dow Chemicals, they have a factory floor. That factory floor is today equipped with traditional industrial Ethernet. We're making it wireless. We're seeing benefits in the form of two areas. First area, when we do this industrial solutions, we think of three basic. We don't think about the speed, we don't think about the latency, we don't think about throughputs, we don't think about location only. We think about safety, efficiency, and productivity. Safety is, can you do the same job safer? Efficiency is, can you do the same job with less effort? Productivity is, can you do more with what you have? And that's what that network did. The Dow Chemical factory increased its productivity by several percentage points. And that's the power of this industry, when we decide to open and collaborate. The third example on the bottom left is essentially a digitalization of the port of Seattle. And you know, if you've ever been to a port, it's not the most fun tourist site to go to. It's a bunch of cranes. They're going into the ships, picking up stuff. The ships come into the harbor. That's how they operate. And the simple metric that they look at is how many ships they can serve in a day, in and out. That's how the success of a port is measured. The port was already well equipped with connectivity with unlicensed Wi-Fi. We augmented that with 5G. And the efficiency of the port went up several percentage points. This is the power that connectivity offers beyond voice and broadband. And the last one is basically working with the federal government on multiple such options, and I don't want to get into details all of them, but basically offering connectivity for a purpose, and more importantly, for an outcome. That outcome is where the collaboration has to come through. If we as an industry are able to quantify that outcome and say, hey, we want to be part of that as a platform, then the telecom industry has succeeded, and the 31 number that we have in terms of total shareholder returns will start to go up. That's my first big message. I'm new to CTIA board, and I'm excited about what we will achieve as a group together, but this is going to be one of the things I bring in, that don't limit as an industry to offer voice and broadband. We need to open, but not just in the way we build networks, but also in the way we offer networks to other industries. The second area of collaboration I want to talk about, actually, there's four more. Where the way we build networks is basically somebody finds a wafer, somebody builds a silicon, the silicon comes, somebody puts software on top of that, somebody builds a system of systems becomes a network, somebody offers a service. It's very simple in one sentence. It takes a generation, 10 years to build it. Now, what we start to see is that supply chain that I offered in about 30 seconds or 15 seconds, that has started to become a little bit more challenged than it used to be because of reasons called geopolitics. We don't get access to everything in the same way. So we need a little bit more resilient and competitive and diverse supply chain. This is where this industry also needs to collaborate. We need to get that wafer, that silicon, that system, that network up and running the same way without any hurdles, despite the challenges. And that's an area that we need to collaborate as an industry beyond ourselves. We think of this industry, this industry will become an AI-powered industry. There's no doubt about that. Whether it takes 2 years, 4 years, or five, doesn't matter. But this industry will become an AI-powered industry, like most other industries. And when that happens, the supply chains get even more challenged. And when that happens, you need to be more resilient, and that's what collaboration brings. The second area, we're talking about 5G, and the summit is 5G, but we need to get ready for 6G. And when you say we need to get ready for 6G, it's both in terms of inventions, concepts, and spectrum. And that's where the partnership with the US government is important. You want to build a 6G, a generation which is inclusive, and it is progressive. You just don't want another generation for the sake of it. It creates more progression, it creates more inclusion, and that's what I am pretty sure that everybody in the room wants, that's what the US government wants, that's what the players in the industry want. One of the big topics is, how do you collaborate to get spectrum? Well, show the best use of it. And simple mantra that I want to share on spectrum is, spectrum is good, licensed spectrum is better, contiguous licensed spectrum is the best. And that's what you want to do in collaboration. The last part of collaboration is basically supporting regulations. And this goes from city jurisdiction to state jurisdiction to federal jurisdiction, supporting the, this is a heavily regulated industry for a good reason. It's the fabric of our essential lives. And we want to make sure the regulatory support is there. And that's where this industry needs to be even more collaborative. That's my message, collaboration. We need to lift the industry. Let's make an industry that is proud of delivering value to every consumer, every enterprise, and to itself. Thank you very much.